Hey, no, you know what's up.
Come on. Saturday night party. We're live.
I know what's up. And I want you.
Partying every Saturday night with the friends. Join us. Hey, waiting for everybody to join us. Let's go! Zero followers, and that's okay because we're having a good time. We're waiting for everybody to come in. If you ain't rocking with us, it's okay. Scroll by, find the next guy. Epoxy Live is coming through. Tonight's topic, white epoxy floors.
No more late night please.
No more VIP.
No more dough.
We can't even kick it no more.
No more late night.
Let's go as we get ready for tonight's live.
What's that?
Tonight's topic, white floors. Why you should charge more money. Let me get some of these guys in here tonight. All right, let's go. We're going to get this thing started. I'm sweating. We already had a dance party before this. Let's go. Getting it started. We got UPUHKK in the building. Woo!
Sweating.
Who's that? Oh, this is the real jam over here. Come on. It's hot. 3 minutes and 53 seconds. We out of shape. I'm out of shape. My wife's ready to roll. We're going live. Look at that. Nobody's ready to join. Nobody wants to join the live chat tonight. It's all good. All right. Welcome. We're going to keep the music flowing a little bit. Talk some epoxy floors. Let's see here. I'm going to try to get some guys in here. Yo, Alanette, Tell your hubby to get on here since he told me he was going to be here tonight. Share this. All right, let's get this thing started. We're going to talk about white floors and epoxy countertops. Why do people want them if allegedly they're going to turn white or they're going to turn yellow on? That's what somebody suggested we talk about tonight. I also wanted to talk about how to hire good employees, how to keep them, how to get rid of them right away, how to train them, how to manage them. That's another thing that I want to talk about tonight. Hiring good employees. I'm going to see if Sean's going to come up in here because I did. See if we can get a couple guys going up in here. Chris, in epoxy floors now, let's go. I need somebody to join the party. I'm inviting you. Chris Elam, let's go. Don't be shy. Everybody can get it in tonight. Clovis Alves in the building. Tonight's topic, white epoxy floors. Some people don't even like to do them. Countertops, which is Dan's hand specialties. Not a big fan, but bro, he kills it. And I want to talk about hiring good employees. As soon as we get somebody in the live, we're going to cut the music. Otherwise, we're doing throwbacks. 90s, early 1000s. I'm dying of heat. I get out, you know, we struggling out here, but his AC's hurting. White epoxy floors, why don't they work? I'm at work, I'm just going to watch. All right, Chris, I don't believe you. I want you to prove to us you're working right now. A lot of shy guys on here, they don't want to get on. I'll honor your word, bro. Yes, I'll be your wife. Come on. Come on, bro. Join me. Join me, Poppy. We're going to talk real stuff here tonight, all right? White epoxy floors. A lot of guys, they're charging more money, okay? If you're $850 a square foot guy for a white floor, you're coming in at like $11, $12. Countertop guys, I don't know the price, really. It's not my forte. We got somebody joining us here. I can't see their face. Let me shut the music off. Nope, they left. They left. Come on. Welcome to the party, everybody. Tonight's topic, again, we're talking white epoxy floors. We're talking hiring employees for your decorative concrete business, firing them, and how to manage them as well. But if nobody's joining me, I'm going to give my 2 cents, and then we're going to keep it moving. I know it's Saturday night. People got stuff to do. Gildian Cardoso. Let's go. Let me shut the music off. Hold on. Marco's here. We need a nice conversation tonight. Talking white epoxy floors, hiring employees, countertops. All right, come on, folks. We're wasting time here, 10 minutes. Who wants to come on and discuss doing white epoxy floors? They're kind of a pain. Where do I start? For one, they're yellow. Two, you can see everything that falls inside the floor. Three, if you don't have the floor nice, flat, and flush, you're going to see some raising above. No good. You're going to see that in the epoxy. And that's why it costs more money. You got a bunch of guys spectating, nobody coming in. Let me try victory. Let me see here. I need you in my life. Come on. Kunal, what's up, bro? It's hot in here. AC don't work that well. I have to go back to a self-leveler that we poured on Friday night. Super humid in the basement. We had a nice wet mix, and we went back today. I had to tell the customer, yo, we got to let this thing dry a little bit more. Mad cold in the house, all right? The AC was working absolutely great in there. Brand new AC, super, super cold. Basement's cold. Watering had nowhere to go. I went back, went to my mom's house, took 3 dehumidifiers, put them in the basement. We'll be back Monday to finish it. Nobody's able to join. I guess, you know, most people, they have a life on a Saturday night. Been in my bed. Little old school Drew Hill. I guess it's old school now, you know. Giving you life. Ain't nothing to say here tonight, folks. You guys got guys watching, they don't wanna join in. How about this? Ask your question. Nentor, you wanna get in on this? Go live. Let's go. I need Nentor to come up in here. He's an ex-Jedi. Alright, Nentor does plenty of white floors. He can tell us the struggles of putting down a white floor. Don't be shy, my friend.
What?
Oh, what's up? What's going on, bro? Mentor, how you doing, brother? Are you in the self-driving Tesla right now?
I am in the truck. No Tesla for me anymore.
What happened? You give it back? You crashed it? What happened? It blew up on you?
Us concrete people, we don't like electric. We only like diesel and gas.
So Nentor is probably the only... Actually, you know what? Nah, I've seen other guys come in there with Teslas. But
Nentor's
an innovator in it.
Setting the bar a little higher in the industry.
You know, I wish you did have it right now, so this way, you know, you could talk to me, put the lights on, relax, kick back, put your hands up.
I wanted to come when you were talking to the other epoxy guys, and
yeah.
I think it's a great thing you're doing, bro. Honestly, it's one of the best things to unite everybody who's doing this, because there's not a lot of us out there.
There isn't. There's a chosen few.
Yeah.
We've been chosen by God to put down great floors. And we got to stick together and help the rest of them come in. So now I'm seeing a couple of the other names coming in. So what do you think? First of all, what are you doing? You about to go to the nightclub or something? What are you doing?
No. I'm about to go grind some concrete.
Oh, yeah?
Actually, I just finished one bakery about 3,000 square feet. And
okay.
It had 3 layers of epoxy on it. So we had...
Damn. What did you do? You bust out the prep masters?
Yeah, prep master with 30 diamonds, it wouldn't take it out. So I had to take the PCDs. And then the problem is when you grind it with the PCDs, it leaves like big scratches in the concrete because it was soft.
Yep.
And then we had to hit it 30 with a metal, 80. And then I'm planning to come to the shop and get the seal.
You're gonna seal it?
Yeah, because I don't think it's worth it to take it all the way to 800. They didn't want it, like, natural shine. They just wanted the coating over it. So I proposed to them, the cement coat you put on top.
Okay. Yeah, it's probably better for a bakery. I mean, polished concrete, what can you do with that?
How are those new grinders you put in the in your Instagram? The ones, the 7-inch ones, they good?
What, the ones that I showed the other day, the Diamond Pro ones?
Yeah, yeah. You had like 3 boxes, right?
I got a whole bunch. I love them. The 5-inch hand grinder I used to not like. We bought a couple. They blew up on us. They give us new ones. These new ones were updated. So they're definitely more. The 7-inches, they never have problems. They're always good. But these 5-inch variable speed, you know, normally there's always an issue with that variable speed mechanism.
They end up getting
real hot.
No,
these new ones are heavy duty. We've been using them for a couple months now. Say what?
Do they have a shroud for the dust?
They don't come with the shroud, but you can buy the shrouds. And then they're universal, so you can put them on anything.
Yeah, I figured usually the small ones don't come, but I have a Metabo. It's like a $400 grinder. Beautiful. But the demo day looked fun, man. I wish I could be there. I was working. But I was.
Yeah, bro. I wanted to see you over there, man. What were you doing?
Grinding concrete.
Come in a little choppy.
I'm running crazy for concrete.
For those who don't know, my brother right now, he does, what's the name of your company? Shout your company out. Basically, he's into the terrazzo business. A lot of polishing, a lot of prep masters, a lot of wet grinding. Shout your company out. Tell them how long you guys been in the business.
And Alessio is the one who got me into the epoxy business also. First time I went to buy epoxy from him. And the first time, second time, third time, I'm professional. You go in there, they treat you like your family.
Yeah.
I know, bro. Listen, I'm going to come to the shop and we can do a live together.
Yeah, we need to. We need to. Now we got a whole new setup. We got the racks over there. We got a nice big open spot. We're going to be doing a lot of different stuff over there, you know, a lot of videos. We want to do some seminars, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll get you to come in and do some terrazzo for us.
With the terrazzo, we need to set a demo day.
You know, actually, this guy Ray came through. He works for the union. He's a union terrazzo guy for a long time. That's all he does is terrazzo. So he was there for demo day. And
he just polished.
No, he lays it down.
Nice. You don't get a lot of people like that, trust me. It's a old school business. Like, it's very rare to find people like that.
Exactly.
That's why the prices are so high for terrazzo right now.
Yeah, you know, he was saying the reason why it's so expensive, too, is when you install those floors, they want these, like, 20-year, 30-year warranties on them.
Yeah, with cement, no way. With epoxy, maybe. But concrete is going to crack for sure. 10,000%.
I think they do the resin, too, the epoxy terrazzo stuff.
Yeah, they usually come with a 4-gallon part A and 1-gallon part B. And you mix them up in the machine, you know, the big mixer?
Yeah.
And then you...
Yeah, like a barrel mixer.
Yeah, mix up the stones and whatever. But definitely we should do a demo day for the terrazzo and the concrete grinding. The heavy-duty stuff, you know?
I really want to do it. Bro, for terrazzo, I feel like there's a lot of people that want to get in it. Actually, Mape, they came in, they brought some samples, terrazzo samples. They have a nice cementitious terrazzo mix that works with their polishable ovaries.
I bought these stones, and they glow in the dark green. So basically, they absorb the sun energy and they glow in the dark.
Yeah.
And then I laid them down on the terrazzo. It's kind of like a poolside terrazzo.
Yeah.
And when you grind it down, and the stones, they glow up, man. It's beautiful. I'll bring you a couple of samples.
Nice, man. I've seen that. Even in Vegas. In Vegas, they take these chrome aggregates. They throw it in the concrete. So when you're walking on the sidewalks at night, it you get the little bling. It catches the bling off the moon as you're walking. It's phenomenal.
Yeah. But these ones are like real stones. I don't know what they call like in English, but I know they call phosphorus, you know? Like the material they use for like signs, so like that it glows back to you, you know?
Glow in the dark?
Yeah, they glow in the dark naturally. It's sick. It's really nice.
I've done some metallics. I have the metallic powder that glows in the dark. We did one with we have blue, yellow, the green color or whatever.
I don't know if you did that job with multiple colors. I think there was like a pink, purple, green, something like that. They were laid down like this.
Yes. That was a victory. That was a victory. I posted that because we did a live video of him installing it to show everybody how he does it.
That looked amazing, bro. No bubbles, no nothing. That looked like...
Yeah, it looked good. I don't know. I think he did a vapor barrier on it. He did a vapor barrier, then he did a base coat, and then he put that down.
But do you think that when this guy did the top coat high performance or not?
No, that's the whole thing. That's what we battle over every night. He doesn't do any top coats. He just leaves it with the epoxy.
Man, it looks... Honestly, if they were to have a top coat to leave it the same way, like it's...
He does.
Yeah, it looks wonderful. But I think the top coat that we put, usually it's much more resistant than the other one, that the epoxy.
It's better than no top coat, and you're absolutely right. But over there, he's down in like Miami, South Florida. Everybody likes the high gloss, very shiny. Kind of like terrazzo. Terrazzo's high gloss, no?
Yeah, I mean, it depends. Some people like it home finish for their houses mostly when it's residential, because usually shiny is the lobby, and I polish it with a compound. You ever did that?
No, compound like a wax or something?
No.
Oh, you mean the sand?
Yeah, exactly. So the compound can be shined down with the compound. They use the same thing for metals to make it shiny. And I use the metal ones in the terrazzo because it's much stronger. And it comes out like... It naturally kind of like shines the stone up. So
let me ask you, when you use the compound, that he's talking about a powder that you throw into the floor while the floor is wet. What are you using, a white pad on a buffer? How do you work that?
A buffing machine, and you use a red pad. And you, some guys, they put a lot of water. They think the water is going to make it more strong, but you actually need to use a little bit, because if you lose a lot, it's going to dilute it, and it's not going to come shiny.
Right.
But you just a little bit, kind of like when you're polishing the car, and with a buffer, and you just stay on it for a while, it's going to naturally kind of like close the stone and make it really shiny.
And when do you start using compound? Like when you're doing terrazzo, explain to us from start to finish. Let's just say... Let's go two ways. Let's go when you start from scratch, brand new terrazzo, you're going to cut with metals, whatever.
Yeah.
Explain to us the steps, and then explain it to us when you already have an existing terrazzo and you're coming in and bringing it down and bringing it back up.
Well, usually when we do the cement, because I 99% I do concrete terrazzo, we kind of scratch the floor, scarify it, so it has a grip on it, and then we clean it with a vacuum. I think cleaning is the most important thing because nothing's gonna stick to dust with epoxy, with everything. And then we lay down the metal dividers. You can have them in brass or silver. I usually like to do 5x5 cubicles because the divider is gonna prevent if it was just one piece. So if it's gonna crack, it's gonna crack in one, let's say, tile, right?
Square, yep.
Yeah. And then one day we pour it down. We use it's like a cement rolling thing to kind of bring the juice up, because usually the cement juice stays down.
Yeah, you mean like a spike roller or something like that?
Spike roller, but with a cement. So you kind of lay it on top of the terrazzo, so it brings the juice up and it compacts the stone the way they should be. And then tomorrow you go grind it, but we use white cement. If you leave it for 2-3 days, it becomes very strong and you cannot cut it. So we usually go the next day and we cut it right there and then. And then usually you have holes because the machine is going to chip out when you're using 30, you know.
Yeah.
It's going to chip out like the small stones. So you got to fill those up and then hit it again with the 50 diamonds, take the scratches off. Then 100, 200, 400, 815. So basically, when you're at 1500, you got a perfectly smooth, a little bit shiny terrazzo floor. And then we use the compound and the sealer.
So basically, after 1500, that's when you start throwing the sand in there, the compound to help. And what kind of compound, what grits does the compound come in?
It doesn't come with a grit. It's an acid compound. Basically, it's made out of acid, and they call this thing, it's like a yellow powder. It's called 5X. Usually, they sell it in stone box. When you mix those together, the acid will give a lot of shine to the stone naturally. It's not like you lay it down and you wait for it to dry.
Okay, I thought you were talking about like abrasives, like when you throw the abrasives down. I've seen a lot of guys do restoration where they throw a fine. It's kind of like a 1500 grit sand or something, and then they buffer it. So you're talking about an acid.
Yeah, this is an acid. It's basically making the floor shiny by itself, you know? You just got to bring it.
Look at this guy. This is the guy that doesn't use the top coat. Miami Vice up in here.
I'm on vacation, dog. We're in the Florida Keys right now. We got our big old RV park right here. Chilling, got my Hawaiian shirt on.
Find us over there, man. We coming right now.
Come on, let's go. Let's party. I got a few drinks in me, so this might be a good podcast.
This guy looking real loose right now with this shirt all the way down to his belly button. Oh, he got a couple buttons.
It's Miami.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
He got his flamingo shirt on, and he's about to go catch 1,500 crabs.
It's Hawaiian night. It's Hawaiian night tonight.
Nice. So you doing the crab thing over there? You get on the boat today? What's going on?
No, I missed the boat. That was yesterday. I got stuck on the job site, so I couldn't make it.
Nice. And where are you guys at exactly? Key Largo?
No, we are in Fiesta Key. It's just south of the lower middle Keys.
Fiesta Keys.
Fiesta. It's like a
Fiesta
park.
Fiesta.
Yes.
All right, man. We got a late start today. You know, we started off jamming out 90s classics. Me and the wifey dancing, waiting for people to come in there. Ain't nobody came in. Mentor came in. Oh man, what is that? Air Maxes, something like that, 95s.
Yes, sir. Throwback. Mentor, you talking about? You know, I was got friends.
Mentor, are you going to grind or are you going out somewhere?
No, man, I'm going out. Enough grinding for the day. I'm loaded with cement, right. So gotta take a few drinks to take it down.
You gotta relax. Okay, I feel you. My man's drinking Twisted Teas. That's a 90s throwback right there.
Yeah.
The early 2000s.
Yo, gentlemen, have a great night.
Mentor, thank you for...
Albania.
What?
I'm neighbor. I'm Albanian. He's Italian. I'm Albanian. We in the same boat.
I'm Croatian. I'm Croatian. We're on the same
boat. Not far.
Same boat too. Kako si? Dobra.
Dobra, dobra.
We took a boat, and Chris came on one of those, like, what do they do, those, the rowboats, you know, competitive rowboats. We went.
Now he knows how to use the squeezy perfectly from though, because he trained his arms.
That's right.
That's it. I hear they got a great, what do they call that? The Harvard teams over there, they're doing a lot.
Yeah.
rowing team.
Yeah, you guys like a big rowing, the big rowers, right?
Yeah,
rowers, I guess. That's what, or paddles, what they call them, paddles, something like that.
Yeah, something.
Yeah. I don't know, am I just speculating there? Or maybe they do like a lot of ships or something like that.
I don't know.
I don't know, man, these Croatians.
They
all right.
Are European, but enjoy your weekend, guys.
I'll mentor, thank you, brother.
You too, man.
Join us soon, man. Have a good night.
Thank you, bro.
Peace. All right, bro. So what's good, man? We were supposed to. Your boy Roberto told us, you know, he hit me up. He's like, yo, let's talk about white epoxy floors, countertops. Like, listen, don't do them. You know what I'm saying? Like, what is there to say?
All right, so that's my mom right there. Hi, Ma.
How you doing, moms? Croatia in the building.
Sir, I'm first generation American. Both of my parents are immigrants, man, from the immigrant here. But white floors, yeah, I don't do white floors unless someone's gonna pay me like $20 and I tell them it's gonna turn yellow and that's it. So but now but now there's another company out there who's they're trying to they've got a polyaspartic, and it goes down as metallic, and it goes down like a nice. It goes down. I did a table at my house, and came out really nice, and it hasn't turned yellow, and it's by my like window. I have like a bay window in my dining room. Hasn't turned yellow.
What about the pigment? Is the pigment stable?
Yeah. The pigment. I don't even know what pigment I used. I might have used Elite Greets pigment.
That was my whole thing.
What?
So you can have everything yellow, but if the pigment ain't UV stable, then how is that going to work?
I don't know.
The powder
can turn yellow?
No, the powder ain't going to turn yellow in poly.
Powder won't.
You can do all white floor and all poly. You do two white base coats, 200 square feet per gallon. Do the metallic at 75 square feet per gallon. Put the powder in the B of the poly. It'll never turn yellow, ever.
You know what? I was thinking liquid pigments. So, yeah, you got a point there. The nitric oxide or whatever they call that. The oxide pigments don't turn yellow.
My guy did a white metallic floor, right? He did a white metallic floor, and what he did was instead of one 12-ounce powder pigment per, he did three powder pigments in the epoxy, never turned yellow. Crazy. You did the white floor with Rock Hard 2 years later. Well, that's luck.
Still white. Still white. Yep. White. And I did an Asian restaurant, and I went the other day to go check on it. It's been like a year. I did an Asian restaurant. I went to go check on it, and it's the restaurant's closed. I couldn't even get in to look at the floor, to be honest. So I don't know if that one's.
Oh, the Asian looks. One. You pulled up the other day on FaceTime. They're not even open.
It was closed. Yeah. I was like, damn.
Yeah, I did some demo today, right? Like, at my boy's crib. He had these hardwood floors. And you know how here, it's not, they're not like nail. They got that thick, like, it's like thick glue or whatever it is. And he had like the little Edco rental from Home Depot.
Oh, jeez.
Yo, the scraper. Yo.
he dug into that floor, didn't he?
Bro. No, it was just so hard. You have to, like, you take the flat bar, rip off one piece, rip the glue, then you rip the whole row off. And then we tried demoing this this big chimney, bro. We
had, like,
we got a 2x6, and we were hammering the 2x6. Dude, it was crazy. Like, I got, like, my hands are red.
Oh, my God.
he's like, oh, what do you suggest to do with all this tile? Because it's all tile that has to be demoed. I'm like, you hire someone, get a ride-on scraper. Like, I'll get you a guy that'll come give
you how many
a
square feet?
Hi, Chris.
3,000.
I ain't doing that shit.
I know you ain't doing it.
Roberto's the one that got me this 12,000 square foot job.
Yeah. Oh, the one that you called me on with the diamonds?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're too cheap to buy the right diamonds, that one?
Oh, the machine can't handle it. I get that propane turco on there.
No, the machine can handle it, buddy. The baby mammoth can handle that floor. You just got to put either the trap adapters with the two-bar traps or the 3-inch round 6-seg metal.
That's what I need, the 3-inch round 6-seg metals. That's what I'm using right now.
That'll tear that floor right up.
Eating right through, bro.
What, to move ground?
It's not even ground. It's mud set. Like,
it's like thin. It's thin set. It's like this.
Mud set, not thin set. Mud is different.
Sorry. All right. My bad.
It looks mud set is like more dry. It's like a dry patch.
Roberto, are you on mute?
What?
There you go. I can hear you now.
You just wasn't saying nothing.
I was just listening. I was learning.
Hawaiian
3000s.
Hawaiian Chris, he's dressed like it's his birthday. He's going on a luau, bro.
It's Hawaiian night tonight. Oh God, my back.
Where?
Unbutton that shirt. A couple more. I mean, you might as well.
This guy with the
net buttoned at all. What is this guy?
Let me see. Oh, we got the Air Max 95s on.
With the gum bottom.
Okay. Fresh.
If Miami was a picture, there you go. This is the guy.
You look like you belong in the Fiesta video. Like Alessio was saying. Alessio knows his hip-hop, bro.
We got the old throwbacks on tonight. I got to get it. Oh, my goodness. So, yo, this is the guy, Roberto. He's the one that brought up the topic for tonight. I went with it. I put out the bat signal, which nobody replied to except for this guy. White floors, which Danny so eloquently stated for us. They made a good point, too. If you use the oxide powder, the powder pigments, they don't turn yellow.
Okay. If
you could run it in polyaspartic, then that's a different story. But you get all these guys that are out there pushing these Carrera marble floors and these countertops, and I've yet to see one that isn't a picture that's either still wet or it dried overnight. But you won't see a picture 6 months later or a year later. Nobody shows a picture. Oh, this is my Carrera marble floor I did last year.
I have one that I did like that I went back and looked at, or I followed a guy on Instagram, and they still look good. That's the rock res, or not rock, what's it called?
Rock hard.
Rock hard from this guy, from Danny.
I did one. My boy said, man, it was my best friend's house. I did his, and it's yellow. It's not like yellow, but it was a pearl metallic.
Yeah,
dog. Yeah.
And I went down there. I'm like, I don't know. It's pearl, champagne. You know what I mean? Like, this is what it is. Yeah.
If you use the charcoal pearl from Elite Crete, that shit's already yellow. That's the earth guy.
This is like the torginal color. You know what I mean?
You're allowed to say that? I didn't think we were allowed to say that word.
What's that?
Yo, Elite Crete? Roberto is not a fan of Elite Crete. Let y'all know.
Okay.
Hey, a lot of people aren't.
I know a lot.
You know what? Look. Everybody came up from that, bro. I came out of that school.
Sure did.
I still like that PT1. You know, when I came up with my epoxy, I wanted it to perform and act like PT1, bro. Roll it, and it melts back out. Yeah, I know they had some consistency issues, but you know what? Everybody got to start somewhere. They were like the only game in town. That's how I came through the door.
Look, that's where I started. But that's why I had the problem with them, because I started there, and then they taught me everything to install commercial outdoors. And then as soon as they started having issues, they're like, oh, well, if you read the fine print, technically you're not supposed to use it outside and all this shit. And I'm like, hold on a second, bro. You're selling me 150-gallon drum kits for the last 4 or 5 years. And yeah. Now all of a sudden, I should have known that we shouldn't be doing this outside, but you trained me. I got videos of your guy out here showing me to do this shit outside. Now all of a sudden, Polly, so your Spartacol is not supposed to go outside? Come on now.
And they discontinued polyaspartic a while ago, too. But now you started off with only knowing what they taught you. Same here. Yeah. And you started researching, reading, and learning. And then, you know, but it was your foot in the door. $150, right? Well spent now, right?
That's just like $300. Yeah.
How much is it?
I think... 300. I think that's what I spent. I think I spent $300. That's what I remember when I told you this story. That's where it was. I went to an Elite Creek course, didn't do nothing, and then 3 months later, I hit that first job where I bought the Terraco 3100 LP. So I mean, it was dope. I appreciated them, and I posted about them like, hey man, these people went. They changed my life from a handyman to you know, 500,000. I never would have thought we'd be making the money that we make now, but when they left me hanging like that, I took that shit personal. I'm from California, so we're borderline gang related. So to me, it was like Elite Crete or nothing. And then when they just left me out to dry, I was like, all right, well, here we go then. No. I called them all out. Haven't seen nobody since.
Did you start off in? Oh, listen, they're all independently owned, you know. Controlled from the top down. So, you know, each guy is different. I know a lot of good guys in the industry from Elite Crete, you know, it's good reps. Most of them are good people. And unfortunately, you know, sometimes the sales guys are trying to make that schmatto. And they end up, you know.
Yeah, brother.
end up doing people a little dirty.
Hey, you know, it happens. But hey, like I told them, they're the ones that have to sleep at night. You know, every time they walk into the bathroom, there's a mirror there. They got to look there. So it's on them. But still, I want to try a white floor and polyaspartic because the epoxies, I haven't seen a white floor and epoxy yet. And if this rock resin does it, then, you know, I could start offering it. But to me, I just tell people, no, I'm not doing it.
I don't know if you guys recall, but I'd met a guy in Jersey that manufactures a bunch of different products. He's got one that he takes an epoxy, he puts it through some light UV treatment, changes it into an aliphatic, makes it UV stable.
How the fuck?
That's what I said. But guess what? He says it is, so I'm going to follow up with him. If that thing works and does it, he said it flows out. Guys are using it for metallics and stuff. Here's my baby. Look, she's coming here, not sleeping. She's supposed to be sleeping right now.
Oh, I remember.
Dad's too loud.
I got my 12-year-old dog bro. Here. Say hi, G. Hi. 12-year-old dog.
Hi.
So, she got the MX 95 triple white on the bottom.
Got all kinds of shoes.
Who's Jay. That? What's that? No. Hi.
Damn, it's half of shit.
So listen, how about this? If I get that epoxy, I'm going to send it to Chris, have him go do his little vertical line, bang, bang, boom, don't yellow. All right, we got something else. Maybe Danny can give me a little hookup, push it through the XPS channels, and then we can all make it.
Bro, that's gold. That would be gold because everybody wants Carrera marble floors, bro.
Yeah,
that's
everybody.
But what is the finish on that, Alessio? Is it still going to have, like, the orange peel?
No, it's epoxy. It's 100% solid epoxy.
So it should glass out.
It's going to glass out like epoxy. It's epoxy. That's an aliphatic epoxy. There's no urethane. It's not a hybrid. None of this stuff. It's 100% solid epoxy.
I wish I had the photo of the outdoor patio in all white metallic poly, because, yo, that shit it looks good, man. It's got, like, black veins in it. I'm going to have to drive down there. It's like Michigan Ave in Miami. You know where that is, Chris?
Nah. try to stay away from that place.
I did interior with the old CTM. These two guys. This is when I was selling jobs. It was like 2,800 square feet. But they only had that one window. That's the one where I did the white flake outside on the patio.
I think I know what you're talking about. But the CTM floor, I remember them doing a bunch of Miami floors outside. They had that long pot life poly, high solids poly spartan.
But I did indoor their apartment, and then I did all white metallic. They wanted it. I told them it was going to yellow. I gave them a ridiculous number because I didn't even want to drive down there because it was an hour away. And they just, oh, okay. And the guy wired me the money that same day. Oh, he gave me his American Express. And I'm like, I hate taking credit cards. But he wired me the balance. And then on the patio outside, he wanted to do some other crap. I'm like, yeah, just do all white flake. Do all white flake. It'll look fine. I did all white flake, all poly. Came out beautiful. I went there a year later. It didn't amber yet. But he only really had... On the east side, he had the big windows, but they had blinds on them, you know, and then the patio door. And they called me to do something else, so I sent my other guy out there. This is like 6 months ago, and that main apartment never ambered, you know. But that's just luck, too. I mean,
Did you get stable?
No, I did the metallic on the inside, and I did the flake in all poly outdoors white.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying, are the flakes themselves UV stable?
Yeah, if they come from Torgonol. Yeah,
flakes are UV stable. Yeah, because I've done a bunch of pool decks for people. Okay. I've sold, these guys came to the training towards Tampa. All they did was pool decks with Laticrete's vapor band, broadcasted the chip into it, two coats of polyaspartic, which... I don't know. I mean, it's just crazy for me to do people that do flake around a pool, but if that's what they want, I mean,
yeah.
You know,
yeah, I'm not big into that either.
Yeah, but
polyaspartic by nature is a little yellow.
It is. One of the parts is, I think the part B or something is got a little yellow tint to it.
Especially yellowish. Especially now.
It's more yellow now.
I never knew about flakes turning yellow. Like, I didn't know that was a thing. I was like, all right, it's just the materials that we use or pigments, like you're saying, turn, but the liquid pigments turn yellow, not the powders, right? So me and a buddy of mine, we did about 26,000 square feet of quartz. On some docks.
No, shit. We
were the material.
You what?
No.
The harbor people, the people over there order this material, 26,000 square feet, double broadcast quartz.
Oh my God.
The dock master ordered it. Really? We showed up with this because the owner of the previous company that was installing it died. So then they called a rep and they said, hey, who do you know that could do a double broadcast quartz into polyaspartic. And this polyaspartic was like from, where was it, like?
In Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania or
something like that.
Somewhere weird. Yeah. This shit was like you had to mix it for 10 seconds and cut it with xylene, something crazy.
Bro.
And he had like 6 to 10 minutes of work time or else that shit was dry. You could walk across it.
Crazy shit.
So we did these docks. They had a container out on the side full of quartz and polyaspartic. So we figured out how to run this. We could run it 26 feet at a time. Every 10 minutes, we could run 26 feet. Less than 2 months, 3 months after we did this job, the whole docks that were this cinnamon red quartz were bleached white. So the dock master had ordered.
They were cinnamon red quartz.
Yeah.
Like the red quartz.
It was like red, tan, and some other color.
Sounds like the coating got something, humidity.
No, it was the quartz. The quartz were interior not UV stable quartz.
Oh yeah, yeah. They do make two different kinds.
Yeah, yeah, there's like
invented those UV stable ones.
Yep. Yeah. So so he's like, man, I don't know what's going on, and I made a couple phone calls trying to figure out, you know, what was happening, and then the people that he had ordered the quartz from was like, no, this is what he ordered. He didn't order this. So I had to tell him, like, hey, bro, I don't know what to tell you, but you ordered the wrong shit. I'm not going to tell nobody, but that's on you to figure out how you want to let all these people know with all these yachts that they just spent all this money on 28,000 square feet.
How long
that isn't worth a shit.
That's a $300,000 job.
Dude. Yeah, six figures.
It was crazy.
I got a guy, new guy that's...
what'd you do?
We left it. I don't know what happened. We got paid. We finished the job, and
this was
he was like,
COVID.
You know,
we got shut down right in the middle of COVID during this. We kept working.
Yep.
Right.
We kept working because they shut everybody down, and then we went into the restaurants. All the restaurants that got money started redoing all their kitchens. So that's when we started doing the urethane cements and those the epoxy with sand.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me tell you.
The metallics in the bathrooms.
I got saved by COVID, bro. I took a job last minute to help out a Crown Polymers guy, Adidas job. They're like, this is what we want. We want you to screw this stuff in. It was asphalt. We poured like over an inch. In some areas, an inch of urethane cement slurry, bro. This is what they wanted. Over freaking asphalt, bro. They used asphalt from like the World War era. That's what they had. They put that in the skyscrapers. No, he was like, look, we'll take, you know, it makes sense. We'll take 4-inch screws, bolt it down. It was like 2 inches of asphalt, a little bit of concrete, steel
bolt
bars.
Bolt the asphalt down?
Through the asphalt into the concrete. But the concrete wasn't like everywhere at 2 inches.
Bro, oh, okay, I got you.
We laid it down, looked beautiful, nice, flat, right? But you know how that stuff pulls like crazy.
Yeah.
The only place it didn't pull was on the concrete. There was like one area of concrete around where the elevators are. Bro, these things started like week by week, just started pulling and then ripping up the bolts straight out of the floor. And then COVID hit, bro. And then COVID hit. And then New York City, everybody's like, oh, done. I got paid. I don't have to deal with it. I didn't specify it. I try to be a nice guy. The guy that took the job ended up was being like, bro, I'm not doing it somewhere. I helped the guy out. I would have done it with like self-leveler, something less, you know, that's not going to pull up like that. And I would have done a grind and seal. Nice. They just wanted a great floor. But this guy was like, he didn't have any of that. They just had urethane cement. So he was like, oh, yeah, we'll put urethane cement on it. He didn't take into consideration the pull. Bro, it was one of those things when you have a test coming up and you're like, God, please.
How many square feet
was it? Like, like 4,000. It was like a nice high-profile job from Adidas, like your sneakerhead. Was the Adidas where they do all the models? Anybody's gonna go to this place. All the different floors. They own like 5 floors in this whole building, and like corporate offices type thing. And bro, COVID hit, and I was like, yes. And then it got like worse and worse. I'm like, help out. They just put carpet back on it. I told them, I said, listen, if you want me to fix it, I'll put something else on top. And I'm like, you guys pick this. I just put it down. I did exactly what she asked. If you want me to fix it, and then they ended up. I don't know what happened, bro. Everybody just it got. New York City was one of the worst with that. Almost as bad as Key Largo.
that's the same thing that happened on the docks. Same thing happened on the docks. It was just, hey, look, we didn't specify this. You guys had the material. We just showed up and did our job. So if you want me to fix it, you got to take it all off. So,
COVID
hit. I'm sure they don't mind having a white quartz floor. You tell them, look, I put a color changing quartz. It turns red. COVID made it turn white. Now you got this nice white thing going on. It'll never change colors again.
Yeah,
it only changed it once.
Yeah, 26,000 square feet, bro. Oh my God.
Yeah,
it's like miserable. You commit suicide over that shit. You know?
Oh, that's what I told the guy. I say, man, I haven't told anybody else. You're the dock master, but you're the one that fucked up. I don't know how you want to work that out, bro, but just let me get that check and let me know how you want me to fix it.
Sell them on that white.
The way I would those fix decks. You'd have to do another double broadcast. I would sand that shit, put a coat down, broadcast sand for the first. You would have to go
pigmented.
Fucking
I go pigmented.
I would say pigmented, but pigmented, yeah, you can't just sand it. You can't just like run like scratch it because you still won't scratch it fully. So you either use my Primera shit now that we got this technology. You put Primera on it, then top coat it. You know what I'm saying, son? That's what I'm talking about. Situational products. Or you grind it, rebroadcast. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah,
we got to circle back and offer him something because I'm pretty sure it's still there.
Dude, it's 2 years later.
Dude, I've sold double broadcasts where I just on the first broadcast, I broadcast sand and then I go and then I just on the second broadcast, whatever color they pick. And if they don't want to spend the $10-$11 a square foot on the second broadcast, I broadcast the quartz, top coat it, and I'm out.
What I was trying to say earlier, guys that are doing flakes, you want to set yourself apart. You want to make more money. You want to charge more. Chris, go do these quartz floors, bro. I got a guy over here doing double broadcast quartz floors, killing it.
How much?
People see it and they love it.
How much are selling quartz for double broadcast? How much?
It's going a little too cheap, in my opinion. These are like back in the day, Elite Creek prices. He said he's at like $8-$8.50.
That's too cheap.
It's too cheap, but I think cheap. Because flakes go around that much.
Yeah, but how much is your thing going for then? You see.
You think cement?
Yeah, how much is that going for?
I was doing that at $12.50. That was my hookup price. With cold base, I'm at like 18.
Yeah,
I'm doing it at 18.
Yeah, we're at $20, dude.
Yeah, I was thinking
like cement flurry?
$20.
Okay.
That. And then flake 657 depends where you're at. He's somewhere different. Chris, he's got the name marble, blah blah blah, fucking lines,
bro.
17 coats, 18 coats per gallon. But average guys,
Fatter gold chain. I need a fatter gold chain, bro. September 1st, 650. January 1st, $7.
But, bro, we do 750 here. 750. The last guy I told you, I hit my 10.
Yeah, see, once you're established, you could get those numbers. But there's like 10,000 guys right now in my town offering flakes. I think they pay them. They don't even make money. I think these companies are paying customers to install at their house. That's how cheap they are. It's fucking crazy. That's why it's like a blessing and a curse that I'm stuck in the commercial because I can't get into residential. If I show up, there'll be 10, 15 other motherfuckers that'll show up and do it for half the price.
Yeah.
Shit pisses me off.
You know what's crazy? What used to piss me off when I was selling jobs? I would show up to an estimate and they'd have all three contractors there.
2 minutes.
Yep.
They'd have all of them there.
I wish I could meet them all because I could call them out in person. But I show up and they're like, look, Pablo just left. He said he could do it for $850. I'm like, I can't even buy the materials for $850. What are you talking about?
Yeah, I've been to biz where there's like multiple contractors. And I'm like, bro, like, what are you doing, bro? You're going to like triple book us, double book us? I'm like,
it's pathetic.
Like, yo, here you go. I walk out. I'm like. Yeah. This one was like out of my area. This guy wanted to go cheap, cheap, cheap. I would talk to the other guys. I'm like, yo, if you guys want to buy some stuff, I'm like, come through New Jersey Decorative Concrete Supply. I was like, I'm going to bid it high. I hope you guys get it. Like, I'm going to bid urethane cement. Or it was actually a mortar.
Yeah,
and I was like,
I ain't the one do my business
card. Yeah. Like, yo, if you want some materials, let me know. I'm out. It was like out of the way. Or I hate when you go, then there's like 15 cents. The second I get there, and there's like 18, 15 samples all over the floor, all these different system stains. I'm out, bro. I don't even bother. I'm just like, yo, what is this? I'm out.
Price it high. I price it high.
Shit. What's funny out here is no matter who they call.
20 seconds.
A handful of companies, no matter who gets the job, I'm the one that shows up and does it anyways. Because if I don't get it, I just get subbed out.
Yeah. Cheers, guys. Have a good night. I'm going to party.
Guys.
Yeah, oh, right. Bray's going to sleep.
I'm out. That's it. It's a wrap. We're not coming back Saturday night. Thanks for joining us.